Hi, my name is Brian Rinaldi, and today I want to talk to you about experimentation. Feature flags using LaunchDarkly help you separate your deploy from your release. This means that just because I merged and deployed a change doesn't mean that it's actually released. Perhaps it's only released to my test environment, or perhaps I've used targeting to ensure that only certain people can see it in production. While this can help ensure that features function as expected, it doesn't ensure that I've actually built the right feature. In most cases, the success or failure of a feature, or even a content change, is determined after the fact, after it's been released. Did traffic fall after it was released? Did folks not use the feature? If not, why not? In many cases, we don't have reliable data to answer these questions effectively. This leaves us telling a story that may have some basis in fact, but not really be representative of the actual truth. In the end, we're left to iterate on a feature after it's already been released with limited data coming in about how to actually fix the problem. This is why I believe experimentation can be so powerful. It allows us to get real data that can increase our certainty about the impact of a feature or a change by eliminating the noise that can lead to erroneous conclusions. Let's look at a very simple example. In this scenario, I've created a simple experiment to test the impact of changing the text on my call to action button on my homepage. My hypothesis is that the more important I make the button seem, the more likely you are to click it. LaunchDarkly randomizes this experiment. As you can see, as I click change user, the text from the experiment changes. Note that it doesn't rotate exactly, but randomly serves a variation. So sometimes the same variation may show up multiple times in a row. I'm testing to see whether a user clicks the button and to see which variation gets the most clicks. I can watch the data for my experimentation roll in and see predictions about which is the best option. Of course, this specific test experiment I've created doesn't really have enough data to make a valid prediction, but let's look at a more real-world example here. Using this data, I can now make better predictions about the impact of my change. What makes experimentation in LaunchDarkly so exciting to me is it doesn't require your engineering or your product teams to learn a different tool. They're already using LaunchDarkly for feature flags. This can reduce your speed to implementation and ease getting buy-in from different teams for experimentation. If you're interested in checking out LaunchDarkly's experimentation, check the URL below to get more details. And thanks for listening. Bye.